What's going on, guys? This is Chandler Smith, and in today's video, we're gonna take you step by step everything that you need to know to do the paperwork on a for sale by owner purchase. That way, if you do find an off-market deal, you know how to do the paperwork and lock up that contract. So with all of that being said, let's jump into it. Guys, buying a for sale by owner property can be extremely overwhelming, especially if you've never done it before, and especially when you get into the paperwork side of things. Realtors can be awesome. However, if you can do a for sale by owner property without a realtor, a lot of the time you're gonna end up saving a lot of money doing it that way. And that's why a lot of the properties I've purchased have been for sale by owners. As a matter of fact, I own over $14 million of real estate, and I would say more than half of that has been purchased going through this process. Step number one is to do your research on a couple different title companies. Now, for me, I've had the chance to work with multiple title companies in my area, and I've come to find they're all pretty good. However, some of them are especially good because they have certain people that work in there that really know their stuff. So I am pulled up in front of AmeriTitle. I don't have any deal with AmeriTitle. However, they have been incredible to me over the years. And so we're gonna go inside and show you the next step. All right, guys, so I'm here at AmeriTitle. This is where I do all of my closings for one reason and one reason only, and it is Kylie. So, Kylie, how many properties have you helped me with now? It's been like...
I'd say, including refinances, probably 10-ish.
10 total?
Yeah.
Yeah. And it might have even been more than that because we had some of those commercial ones.
So. That's true.
But ballpark. All right, let's do this. So Kylie, here's the deal. Everyone goes to a realtor to help them with this stuff. Now, you have certain rules working with the title company, but I'm gonna be honest, you probably know more than about 99.9% of realtors. Am I wrong?
Not in all cases, but we do help a lot of new realtors answer questions that their real estate classes don't always teach.
So this is a standard for sale by owner contract. Now, as you can see at the top, it's going to ask you just the basic information. So, you know, address of the property, and then you get to this nifty legal description. Now, if you're in with a Kylie, you tell her the address, and then how do we fill that out?
If you don't know your legal description, your lot and your block, it's pretty normal for that to happen. We can always pull up county records for that address and see if we can find a deed that has a legal description on it. That will at least help you know what you need to fill out right there, or we can probably copy and paste and put see a legal description attached.
So important things, first off, you're gonna get to the purchase price, pretty self-explanatory, you're just gonna fill it out. Then you've got earnest money, again, pretty self-explanatory, right?
Yes. And it's not a requirement either. We have a lot of times people already have all the terms worked out with their seller or their buyer. And if you don't feel like you need earnest money, it's not a requirement. You're welcome to put zeros or NA just about anywhere you feel like it's necessary.
So then we're going to jump down undersigned hereby. What's this one? Sum of.
So that is the amount of the earnest money.
Very cool. And then this is a bunch of stuff that I never read. You can read it if you want to, but Kylie says it's good to go, so I'm not worried about it.
It's pretty standard stuff.
If you don't understand it, Google it, read it, ask questions. It's okay, there's no stupid question. Balance of purchase price to be paid as follows. What is that section for?
That section is for whether or not purchase price minus your earnest money, are you getting a loan for the rest of that purchase price, or are you bringing in cash? So you would put loan, or check, or however you mean to pay for the rest of the transaction.
Very cool. And is that something where you might put like 25% down cash and then 75% loan?
Yeah, absolutely.
So I just asked Kylie about this one. It just has a bunch to do with easements and liens or anything else that might be with the property. All right, Kylie, so what's number 5, 6, and 7 for us here?
Okay, number 5 is what date do you want to have the transaction be fully closed. You no longer own it, or now you do own it. The number 6 is going to be the assessment. So if there's a homeowners association or taxes, we debit and credit each party accordingly so that everything breaks even. Number 7 is specific to those. It's going to be, is there any reason that you don't want us to use the closing date for the date we use on the prorations for county taxes or any other assessments you have on your property?
Very cool. And if I don't know the answer, I can guess, and then you'll tell me if I'm right or wrong on those.
Absolutely. And that's also what we provide, is we tell you what assessments are on your property.
Very cool. All right, guys, so we've covered these. Number 8 is kind of where I hang out. It says the parties agree that this agreement contains the following additional terms and conditions. Anytime I negotiate anything, whether it's an additional 2% on my closing costs or getting them to fix something or handle something, I'm going to plug it in here and make sure that it's done. The other thing I always put here, and I'm probably wrong in this, but I like to write again that I have 10 days to do my inspection period, just to be over the top. Am I foolish for doing that?
Not if that's what it's going to take for you to be comfortable moving forward with the transaction. We're neutral here, so we aren't here to make anyone sign anything they're uncomfortable with. Whatever makes everyone in the transaction feel good about it.
Very cool. So I like to be over the top, making sure they understand, look, I get my earnest money back. If I find anything that is unsatisfactory during that inspection, that's where I'm going to put it. Now, the following items of property now on the premises are specifically excluded from the sale. You can put down those. A lot of times they have stuff, especially a for sale by owner, in the property that they want to clarify you're not taking ownership of. Now, one quick negotiating tactic that I love to use is I love to tell the seller that I want to split all of the closing costs. And a lot of times sellers don't really know that that also means splitting the financing closing costs. And so on all of those, I'll put shared equally. Now, this isn't necessarily shady, but also it really helps you to negotiate a little more help on the deal, because if they agree to split all closing costs, then we can put those are shared equally on all of them. And that's going to save you a big expense. Kylie, thoughts on that?
Thoughts on that are going to be, it really depends on what type of financing you are getting. Not all loan types allow all fees to be shared in specific ways. That's part of what this packet that we have here at our office, if you want to come grab one, it's going to tell you FHA, VA, conventional, what those terms and who can or can't pay what fees.
That's a great thing to know. Now, I've had success with that, getting conventional 25% down loan, but you're saying in an FHA or another situation, it might be hard to get that because you can't get that much of your closing costs covered by the seller.
Right. And there are also some fees that lenders don't allow closing costs to cover. Those are typically for closing costs and prepaids. Maybe it doesn't cover specific fees. So that's going to be a great thing for that packet to tell you specifically. And also, if you have or know of a lender to contact, we love to use Tony Ekman at Idaho Central. He knows everything about that end of things. That's not really my portion of stuff to go into, honestly.
Definitely. Now, truth be told, you know all of this stuff, but you're very good at saying this is who you need to talk to and how you need to do. So we'll leave it at that. But thank you. That is great advice.
You're welcome.
All right, guys. So that is the full contract, but they gave me all of these other nifty papers. So I'm going to go through them in a minute. But if you're trying to push a for sale owner deal through, it's as simple as that. You're going to get it signed. You're going to get it filled out. You're going to bring it over to them, and you are good to go. And Kylie, thank you so much. You literally are the best.
Welcome.
It's funny because I probably filled a bunch of these out, but I still ask you questions on them even to this day, because I'm like, could I word it like this? Or how should I do that? And you're always great at answering with yes or no to get me to where I need to be. So perfect.
Thank you.
All right, guys, I can't emphasize the importance of finding a good title company and someone that can really help you through the process. This is why for sale by owner is not at all intimidating, because if you find the right title company, they can make it so easy for you, because they literally tell you, don't do this, do this. They can walk you through everything, make sure you don't forget anything. The big place you can get worked over is if you don't negotiate properly. So you want to make sure you get your purchase price right. You want to make sure that you give yourself 10 days for an inspection, and you want to clarify that you can get your earnest money back if within that 10-day inspection period, you find the inspection unsatisfactory, or if you can't get financing. You want to make sure you put those things in so you can bail out. You also want to make sure that you get all of the closing costs divided properly, especially if you've negotiated that, so you can put yourself in a place where you can get a big win. So we've introduced you to Kylie. I can't tell you how grateful I am for her and all the help she's been to us. The other thing I'll add is she's always been able to work with me because of multiple properties when it comes to their portion of my closing costs. So this is a helpful hint, and don't abuse it, be reasonable. But someone like Kylie at AmeriTitle, if you go in and you say, hey, do you guys have any wiggle room? She's usually always able to find a way to save you money compared to other title companies out there. And that's just another reason that I love using them. Title companies are just like everybody else. If they compete, you win. So make sure that you get them to compete and make sure you find a good one. It's so important to find a good one because then the process is gonna be smooth and they can make it extremely quick. Because I use a good loan officer and I use an incredible title company, I've gotten to the point where I can close within 15 days of getting a for sale by owner under contract or anything under contract. And that's extremely important to me so you can push deals through. Now, if you do an inspection, this section gives you the ability to renegotiate or kind of change your addendum. And this is awesome because when you do your inspection, you should be pushing them hard to get more off, and you can plug everything in here to alter that agreement. Now, this stuff is just very simple questions, but the seller needs to fill all of this out. This is so you can know what you're getting into. This gives them the opportunity to say any issues with the property. And then everything else is pretty easy. You're gonna need to get your information from your lender. You're gonna wanna make sure you get all the contact info from the seller, from the buyer, get everything plugged in properly, and then you are good to go. Now guys, that's it. And I know it seems extremely simple and you're like, what is a realtor getting paid for? Well, here's the deal. They should understand the market. They should make sure you're getting a good deal. They can help you walk through properties. They can do all of that for you. But if you know what you're doing and you find a killer off-market deal or for sale by owner deal, I want you to know this is not that complicated. It's so worth it to go, to learn it, to figure it out, to go through the process, and you're good to go. And the most important part is just making sure that you've got the purchase price right. And a lot of that comes down to just negotiating and understanding the numbers and getting that done. But then when it comes to filling out the paperwork, you just plug in the number. Same with closing costs. You just need to plug in, you know, you're getting 2% back, or plug in which boxes are which, or negotiate half. And so if you want to learn how to negotiate on these things more, you can go and watch this video and see some of the things that I've done. However, just understand, if you negotiate a good deal, it's not complicated to fill out all of the boxes. And if you do get lost along the way, if you're with a good title company, they're going to give you directions so you can get this filled out. The way that I like to do it is when I get it under contract on a property and they say, yes, we're ready to go, I like to have this ready where I can fill it out right there with them because now I know how to do it. If you're not in that case and you get them to agree on a price, you can come into the title company, you can bring them with you and you can just walk through it with the seller. Or what I prefer to do, just so they don't get cold feet or you don't run into a situation where maybe the title company causes them to have cold feet, is you can go in, you can get it filled out perfectly. You can understand everything on the agreement and then bring the agreement to them and say, hey, this is how it works. This is how everything's done. And if you have any questions, we can go into the title company together. They were the ones that helped me fill it out. And that way, if you've got any questions, they can answer to the best of their ability. So at this point, it's just time for you to go and find a killer deal and get it under contract and not be scared at all when it comes to doing a for sale by owner property, especially if you find a good title company that can walk you through the process. All right, guys, the biggest mistake you can make is not using a title company because they're gonna make sure that it's a clean title. They're gonna help you go through the whole agreement. They're gonna make sure everything's filled out. On top of not using a title company, the other big mistakes you can make is, number one, not negotiating the right purchase price to where your numbers work. Number two, not giving yourself that 10-day inspection period. I can't emphasize enough how important it is to do a full inspection, do all of your due diligence, and make sure that you have that time period so that even if you put in your earnest money, you can get it back if you're not happy with the inspection. And then finally, making sure that all of the right boxes are checked when it comes to closing costs, because that is a pretty large expense and you wanna make sure that you negotiate it to the best of your ability and you don't end up getting taken advantage of or getting stuck with closing costs that you weren't expecting. And again, the title company is going to be able to walk you through that. But also, you need to take advantage of your loan officer and understanding all of those expenses and making sure that you negotiate them so that hopefully, worst case scenario, you're covering half of the total. And best case scenario, you're getting the seller to cover all of those. I'm telling you right now, do your research, shop out multiple different title companies, pick one where you know the person knows what they're talking about. And then it's hard to go wrong with a for sale by owner because you have someone that you can ask those questions and you know that they're gonna go and do the work. It's so crucial that you use a title company. It is not worth saving money by skipping them because they're gonna make sure it's got a clean title and they're gonna make sure that the whole transaction is good to go. And it ensures that process so that if there are issues in the future, you can fall back on them in the work that they do. All right, guys, I know this video was more on the, I'm not gonna say boring, but it's more of the nitty gritty stuff of real estate investing. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you remember to smash the like button, subscribe to the channel, and hit the little bell so you can catch my future videos where my goal is to help you to build a huge passive income. Thanks so much, guys. Have a great day.